It's an extraordinary experience seeing the city like this. I mean, a few party stragglers going by, Gardaí patrolling the empty streets, and knowing that there are human beings huddled in doorways while the rest of us will go home and sleep in comfort.
And we would meet men, women and children who are homeless, and we would meet men, women and children from all walks of life, from architects to professional sports personnel, journalists, ex-Garda, ex-cop, ex-doctor, nurse, right across the board.
Footballer. Football runs in my family.
And you were pretty good, were you?
I was pretty good now. I must say, I should have made it. I chose the wrong path. I stopped going training.
It was a scary feeling when you haven't got a home. But after a while, you kind of get used to it. It's not that you get used to it. It's every day you just say to yourself, well, you know, there's worse people. I see somebody walking by with a white stick, I say, there, I'm not as bad as these people.
I had the best of everything before I came homeless. I had my own van, my own house. I was doing my own work. Coming from the travelling background, I was doing my own markets, my own fairs. I had the best of everything. And in a split second, down to my mother being attacked, I lost everything. I took the law into my own hands. I lost everything. You could have the best of everything. And in a second, that's gone.
So when clients arrive in the evening, they're offered tea and coffee and soup and sandwiches. We sit down for an hour or so, and it's quite a social environment. We chat with the clients, we find out how their day has been.
Unfortunately, we have had a serious drug problem in Ireland, you know, for the last 30 years. It hasn't gone away. The responses that we've had to it haven't resolved the problem. So it is about being pragmatic and saying, okay, look at, obviously the safest thing is if people didn't use drugs at all, and certainly we'd say that to people, but if people are using drugs, we have to accept that reality and choose to either try and engage with them and to make things better, or, you know, just to push them out.
So they will sleep on Grafton Street for reasons like that there's light there, that they would feel a little bit more secure because of the foot traffic, maybe there's a Garda presence and stuff like that. So that would make them feel a little bit more safe. Then there's other people that would choose to either try and use squats, old abandoned buildings, or they'll get in doorways anywhere in and around the city if possible.
There's a strange camaraderie on the streets. Maybe people putting their best face forward when they're talking to me, I don't know. But the kind of desperation I expected to find, I haven't found. Instead, I found an acceptance. An anger, yeah, but an acceptance of the situation and a sense of taking one day at a time.